Okay, good day. Let's go to title 14, which is quasi-offenses. Okay, so the sole chapter of this title is Article 365 or the... Sorry, sole chapter is criminal negligence. So, isang article lang nandito, which is Article 365, imprudence and negligence. So, any person by reckless imprudence shall commit any act which had been intentional would constitute a grave felony, shall suffer the penalty of arresto mayor in its maximum period to prison correctional in its medium period, if it would have constituted a less grave felony, the penalty of arresto mayor in its minimum and medium period shall be imposed. If it would have constituted a light felony, the penalty of arresto minor in its maximum period shall be imposed. So, this paragraph talks about mga taong nakakapag-commit ng reckless imprudence. Okay? So, yung reckless imprudence na yan, well, na-commit yan ng isang tao through his imprudence or negligence. Didiscuss natin pinagkaiba mamaya. But nevertheless, hindi yan intentional. Okay? So, yung na-commit ng tao na to, ng walang intention, if it would have been intentional, pag nag-constitute siya ng grave felony, aresto mayor yung penalty. Okay? If yung act naman would have constituted less grave, iba pa rin yung penalty. And kung light penalty naman, aresto minor in its maximum period shall be imposed. Okay? So, any person who, by simple imprudence or negligence, shall commit an act which would otherwise constitute a grave felony, shall suffer the penalty of arresto mayor in its medium and maximum periods. If it would have constituted a less serious felony, the penalty of arresto mayor in its minimum period shall be imposed. So, imprudence can be committed by two ways. We have reckless imprudence and simple imprudence. Okay? Yung diniscuss natin dito sa paragraph 1, that is reckless imprudence. Yung reckless imprudence mo kapag intention, kung sakaling naging intentional yan, it would have constituted a grave felony, less grave, light, iba-iba yung penalty. Okay? Pero pag simple imprudence naman yan or simple negligence, ganun din, iba-iba rin yung penalty, which is mas mababa yung mga penalties netong simple imprudence compared to reckless imprudence. When the execution of the act covered by this article shall have only resulted in damage to property of another, the offender shall be punished by a fine ranging from the amount equal to the value of the said damages to 3 times of such value, but which shall no in case less than 5,000 pesos. Alright, so this paragraph talks about if yung reckless imprudence mo or yung simple imprudence na na-commit ng isang tao, nag-result siya sa damage to property, walang imprisonment na mai-impose. Okay, fine lang. Fine. Magkano yung fine? Well, it ranges upon the equal value nung damages. Up to 3 times nung value na yun. Okay? But, hindi dapat mas mababa sa 5,000 pesos yung magiging fine. Okay? A fine not exceeding 40,000 pesos and censure shall be imposed upon any person who, by simple imprudence or negligence, shall cause some wrong which, if done maliciously, would have constituted a light felony. So, kapag yung simple imprudence na na-commit ng isang tao, simple negligence, ang naging resulta niyan is magiging light felony if ever it has been done maliciously. Then fine lang rin siya. Okay? Fine lang rin, not exceeding 40,000 pesos. Okay, take notice dito sa paragraph 2 natin, yung simple imprudence and negligence, nag-provide siya ng penalty of imprisonment sa mga acts that would have constituted a grave felony and less serious felony if it was done maliciously. Okay, so walang light felony. Kasi yung light felony nandito. Okay, which is walang imprisonment but a fine not exceeding 40,000 pesos. In the imposition of these penalties, the court shall exercise their sound discretion without regard to the rules proscribed in Article 64. So, well, yung Article 64 is nandyan yung mga aggravating and mitigating circumstance, paano nagvavary yung penalty based on mitigating and aggravating. So, si court, sa pag-i-impose ng mga penalties dito sa simple imprudence or reckless imprudence, nasa discretion niya ng court. Okay? Kahit pa huwag niya sundin yung nasa Article 64. The provisions contained in this article shall not be applicable when the penalty provided for an offense is equal or lower than those provided in the first two paragraphs of this article, in which case the court shall impose the penalty next lower in degree than that which should be imposed in the proper period which they may deem proper to apply. And when by imprudence or negligence and with violation of the automobile law, the death of a person shall be caused, in which case the defendant shall be punished by reclusion correctional in its medium and maximum period. So this paragraph talks about the exemptions doon sa mga penalties na pinrovide dito sa mga preceding paragraphs natin. Okay? So, yung mga penalties na pinagbabanggit natin kanina, hindi siya mag-a-apply if yung situation is pasok dito sa dalawa. Okay? Reckless imprudence consists in voluntary, really, but without malice. Okay? So, ang reckless imprudence is voluntary yan. Voluntary ka nagte-text habang nagmamaneho. Voluntary yun. Ginusto mo mag-text habang nagmamaneho. Okay? Pero, wala kang done without malice. Kunyari, habang nagmamaneho ka, nakabangga ka. Dahil nagte-text ka. So, yung pagte-text mo is voluntarily. But yung pagbangga mo dun sa ano, sa tao, that is without malice. Okay? Nagko-consist din ang reckless imprudence involuntarily doing or failing to do an act from which material damage results by reason of inexcusable lack of precaution on the part of the person performing or failing to perform such act. Okay? So, voluntary mong ginawa or voluntary mong hindi ginawa yung isang bagay na naging sanhi ng damages sa ibang tao. Like, chinek mo yung kotse mo, nakita mo medyo pudpud na yung brakes, hindi mo pa rin pinalitan, minaneho mo pa rin yung kotse na yon, and voluntary mo na hindi pinalitan, alam mo na eh, okay, nakita mo na pwedeng kang maka-aksidente dahil pudpud na yung brakes mo, ginamit mo pa rin yung kotse, and naging result nakabangga ka ngayon ng tao. Okay, so that is reckless imprudence. Sa reckless imprudence, tinetake into consideration din yung employment niya or occupation, degree of intelligence, physical condition, and other circumstances regarding person's time and place. Simple imprudence naman consists in the lack of precaution displayed in those cases in which the damage impending to because is not immediate nor the danger clearly manifest. Okay, the penalty next higher in degree to those provided for in this article shall be imposed upon the offender who fails to lend on the spot to the injured party such help as may be in hands to give. Okay, so didiscuss natin lahat yan. So, summary muna natin ano yung mga quasi offenses under 365. So, meron tayong apat na paragraphs. It means, quasi offenses under 365 are committed four ways. Okay? So, by committing through reckless imprudence, any act which had it been intentional, magko-constitute siya ng grave or less grave felony or light felony. Pangalawa is by committing through simple imprudence or negligence. an act which would otherwise constitute a grave or less serious felony. Dalawa lang. Pangatlo is by causing damage to the property of another through reckless imprudence or simple imprudence or negligence. Property yung na-damage mo dahil sa reckless imprudence or simple imprudence mo. And pang-apat, by causing through simple imprudence or negligence some wrong which, if maliciously done, magko-constitute siya ng light felony. So those are the four acts or the four ways of committing quasi-offenses under Article 365. Okay, dito tayo sa paragraph 1. Linawin natin yung sinabi dyan na act which, had it been intentional, would constitute a grave felony, a less grave felony, or a light felony. So, ganito, parricide under 246 or homicide under 249. If nag-commit ka ng homicide or parricide na yan with intent to kill, intentional, grave felony ang tawag doon. Because the first is punishable by reclusion perpetua to death and yung homicide, punishable siya by the reclusion temporal. So, both afflictive penalties and death is capital punishment. If yung parricide na yan and homicide na yan, kinumit mo yan through reckless imprudence, then Article 365 is applicable. Okay, gets mo? Homicide, parricide. Parricide is a grave felony. Okay? Kapag ginawa mo yung parricide na yan, intentionally, ang crime mo, parricide. Okay? Kasi grave felony yan. Pero, kapag yung parricide na yan, nakomit mo through reckless imprudence, ibig sabihin, walang malis, then it is reckless imprudence resulting to parricide. Or, okay, basta reckless imprudence. 365 yung applicable doon. Less serious physical injuries, Article 265, less grave felony yan. Kasi punishable yan by arresto mayor, correctional penalty. Yung slight physical injuries naman, light felony yun. Kasi punishable siya by arresto menor or a fine not exceeding 200 pesos. So kapag yung less serious physical injuries na yan, na less grave, and yung slight physical injuries, kinumit mo yan with malice, then kakasuhan ka ng violation ng Article 265 or Article 266, which is the provisions of the RPC, which punishes less serious physical injury and slight physical injury. Pero kapag yung physical injuries na yan, less serious, kinumit mo yan through reckless imprudence, then Article 365 applies. Okay? For firing a warning shot, nag-warning shot ka sa air, without the least intention of causing injury to anyone, but without taking the necessary precaution demanded by the circumstances as to the time and place, in the process, hit and killed a bystander. So the accused, who is a policeman, cannot be held liable under 249 for intentional homicide, but instead liable under 365. Okay? May nag-aaway, nag-warning shot, kaya nasa loob kayo ng isang kwarto, nag-warning shot ka sa taas. So may kisa, may bumanda ngayon yung bala, tumama sa ibang tao. Liable ka ba for homicide? Hindi, kasi walang malis naman yung ginawa mo. It was committed by through reckless imprudence because of your lack of necessary precaution na i-take consideration yung lugar kung saan ka magfa-firing shot. Okay, so hindi ka ipapunish under the provisions ng homicide 249. Ang magiging applicable sa'yo is Article 365. Okay? For homicide through reckless imprudence. If the act performed would not constitute a grave or less grave felony or light felony under any provisions of the Revised Penal Code, which defines intentional penalty, felony, then Article 365 is not applicable. Okay? Walang crime na nakomit kung yung reckless imprudence mo hindi siya nag-result sa grave, less grave, or slight. Walang felony because it will be neither intentional felony nor a culpable felony. Okay? Remember na meron tayong two classes of felonies, di ba? Intentional felony by dolo and culpable felony by culpa as provided sa Article 3 ng Revised Penal Code. Okay? Take the case of U.S. versus Villanueva. So, sa facts ng case na to, si accused, suddenly, hindi nagsasalita, bigla niyang binunot yung bolo niya. Okay? Which, si Isidro Benter was carrying at his belt. So, si Isidro Benter instinctively caught the bolo to retain it. And in catching the bolo with his right hand, yung bolo, in sliding through with all its edge, wounded him across the width of the palm of the hand in the direction perpendicular to the base of the fingers. Okay? Yung wood niya, yung sugat na natamo ni Isidro Benter sa paghawak niya dun sa bolo na binunot ng accused, hindi yun gumaling for more than 40 days. So that is serious physical injuries. Okay? But sabi ng court, the accused is not criminally liable for either intentional serious physical injury or for serious physical injury through reckless imprudence. Kasi the law speaks of a person who by reckless imprudence commits an act if maliciously performed would constitute a grave, less grave, or light felony. Pero yung act ng accused does not constitute a felony, grave, or less grave. Yung act niya which he performed was to take. Ang ginawa niya lang naman is binunot yung bolo. Okay? So yung pagbunot niya na yon, hindi yun magko-constitute ng grave, less grave, or slight felony. Okay? Yun lang yung act na pinerform niya. Ngayon, ang ginawa nung ni Benter, yung paghawak niya sa bolo, is an act which is not defined in any law as being a crime. Okay? So, if the accused, kung sakaling si accused in pagkuha niya nung bolo, or if any other person in taking a revolver from the belt of the person carrying it, by not employing proper care, wounded the latter clearly, then he would have to answer for his act of injuring the other as guilty of having caused an injury without malice and merely by reckless negligence by reason of not using proper care. But the defendant did not put Benter. Okay? Si Benter yung gumawa on his own act na hawakan yung patalim ng bolo. And nasugatan siya sa sarili niyang kagagawan. Okay? Or the bolo by its edge or by in its own weight in slipping Benter's hand because hindi niya nahawakan ng maayos, wounded Benter. Yung bolo mismo yung gumawa na ito, hindi yung accused. Okay? Quasi-offenses are distinct species of crime yan. Okay? Yung notion na yung quasi-offenses, whether reckless man yan or simple, take note. Distinct species of crime yan. Separately defined and penalized under the framework ng penal laws natin. Okay? As early in the middle of the last century, the Supreme Court already sought to bring clarity to this field. Okay? Yung proposition sa na-infer sa Article 3 ng RPC natin that reckless imprudence is not a crime itself but simply a way of committing it and merely determines a lower degree of criminal liability is too broad to deserve unqualified asset. Okay? There are crimes that by their structure cannot be committed through imprudence like murder, treason, robbery, malicious mischief. Hindi yan nakukomit through reckless imprudence. Okay? In truth, criminal negligence sa RPC natin is treated as a mere quasi-offense and dealt with separately from willful offenses. It is not a mere question of classification or terminology. Sa intentional crimes, yung act mismo yung pinapunish. Pero sa negligence or imprudence, what is principally penalized is the mental attitude or condition behind the act. Yung dangerous recklessness, yung lack of care or foresight. Okay, yung imprudensya punible. Okay, pag mag-a-allege ka ng quasi-crimes, i-state mo dapat yung commission results in damage either to persons or property. Okay? Kunyari, yung imprudence na nag-result sa homicide, dapat, ang i-allege mo is reckless imprudence resulting in homicide. Kung simple imprudence naman yan na nag-cause sa damage to property, ang i-allege mo, simple imprudence causing damage to property. Okay? When a person by reckless imprudence caused the death of another, ang strict technical offense is more accurately reckless imprudence resulting in homicide. Okay, kapag simple negligence naman or imprudence caused damage to the property of another, ang strict technical offense natin is more accurately simple imprudence causing damage to property. Criminal negligence sa RPC natin is treated as a mere quasi-offense and dealt with separately from willful offenses as sinabi ko kanina. It is not a mere question of classification or terminology. Like I said, sa intentional crimes, yung act itself yung pinapunish. Sa negligence or imprudence, ang pinapenalize dito is yung mental attitude or condition behind the act. Kaya yung dangerous recklessness, yung lack of care or foresight, yung imprudensya punible. Okay? Much of the confusion has arisen from the common use of such descriptive phrases such as homicide through reckless imprudence and the like, when the strict technical offense is more accurately reckless imprudence resulting in homicide or simple imprudence causing damage to property. Yung itong 365 natin na RPC, nag-fix ng penalty for reckless imprudence at arresto mayor maximum to prison correctional minimum. If yung willful act would constitute a grave felony, notwithstanding the penalty for the latter, could range all the way from prison mayor to death. Okay, according to the case yan, syempre. It can be seen na yung actual penalty for criminal negligence walang relation to the individual willful of crime, but is set in relation to the whole class or series of crimes. Negligence under the RPC and yung negligence under the Civil Code. Discuss natin. Okay? So, yung negligent act causing damage may produce civil liability arising from crime or create an action for quasi-delict under the Civil Code. The injured party may choose kung ano yung remedy na i-enforce niya. Kung yung negligent act ba punishable sa revised penal code or yung negligent act nag-a-arise from civil code. Okay? So, pwede siya mamili alin dun sa dalawa. Pwede ba sabay? Pwede ba pareho? Hindi pwede. He cannot recover damages twice for the same act or omission of the defendant. Okay? The penal code does not draw a well-defined demarcation line between negligence acts that are delictual and those which are quasi-delictual. Okay? It is possible na yung negligent act may be delictual and quasi-delictual at the same time. Negligence sa civil law may arise from contract, yung culpa contractual, or tort, culpa aquiliana. Okay, yung imprudence and negligence dito sa 365 title niya. Magkaiba yan, okay? Imprudence indicates a deficiency of action. Negligence indicates a deficiency ng perception. Okay? Hence, yung failure in precaution, it termed in imprudence. yung failure inadvertence is known as negligence. Okay? So let's say yung failure to properly pay attention and mag-act using due diligence, hindi ka nag-iingat in foreseeing them, that is negligence. Okay? Yung failure to take necessary precaution kahit na nakita mo na yung future danger, that is imprudence. Okay? May kandila na nakalagay sa tabi ng kurtina. So you are, may nafo-forcing ka lang, pwede mangyari doon. Pwedeng masunog yung kurtina na yan. But you fail to take the necessary precaution. That is negligence. Okay? So when we say reckless imprudence, this consists in voluntary, okay, voluntary, but without malice, doing or failing to do an act which material damage results by reason of inexcusable lack of precaution on the part of the person performing or failing to perform such act, taking into consideration his employment or occupation, degree of intelligence, physical condition, and other circumstances regarding person's time and place. Okay? So, voluntary yan. Like, example ko kanina, voluntary ka nagte-text habang nagda-drive. Okay? So, yung pagte-text mo habang nagda-drive, nakabangga ka ngayon ng tao. So, nag-result siya ng material damage dahil lang sa lack of precaution sa part mo. Okay? Na mag-act ng due diligence habang nagmamaneho. Mag-ingat habang nagmamaneho. Okay? When we say simple imprudence naman, simple imprudence is lack of precaution displayed in those cases in which the damage impending to be caused is not immediate nor the danger clearly manifest. Doon muna tayo sa reckless imprudence. Ano ba yung mga elements ng simple reckless imprudence? So, reckless imprudence merong limang elements. Okay, una is the offender does or fails to do an act. May ginawa si offender or may hindi siya nagawa. Okay? That of doing or the failure to do an act is voluntary. Yung paggawa niya ng act na yon or yung paghindi niya paggawa ng act na yon, voluntary yon. Okay? Pero walang malice. Tapos dahil doon, material damage results. Okay? And panglima, there is an inexcusable lack of precaution on the part of the offender. Taking consideration yung employment niya or occupation, degree of intelligence, physical condition, and other circumstances regarding person's time and place. Kunyari, pharmacist ka, ikaw yung nag-aayos ng mga gamot, ikaw yung, okay? Napaghalo-halo mo. Hindi ka nag-iingat. Example pa, si A, barista si A, so gumawa siya ng alak, drinks, okay? Timpla siya. Ngayon, gumamit siya ng methyl alcohol, tapos hinalo niya to sa sugar and lemon. Okay? Tapos pinainom niya sa tatlong customer niya. Okay, so walang malis doon, pero voluntary niyang ginamit yung methyl alcohol. Wala siyang intention na patayin yung tatlong inom. Akala niya lang siguro, masasarap yung ano, yung inumin na gagawin niya. Ngayon, pinainom niya sa tatlong tao. Ang nangyari doon sa uminom, they were poisoned, namatay sila. Okay? So, yung alcohol for motor vehicles, yung methyl alcohol, hindi yan proper for human beings. Okay, common sense. Lacking in the simplest precaution, si A committed reckless imprudence. Example nung doing an act which results in reckless imprudence dun sa ano, unang element. So, let's say si A went out hunting, nag-hunt siya kasama yung mga tropa niya. Okay, so while nagahunting sila gabi, si A, nabaril niya yung isa sa mga kasamahan niya. Kasi akala niya, kambing. Okay? So, si A committed homicide through reckless imprudence, hindi niya intention na patayin yung ano, yung kasamahan niya. Pero ang akala niya kasi, hindi siya nag-ingat, hindi siya nag-act with due diligence. Okay? Hindi siya nag-take ng necessary precaution para siguraduhin na kambing ba talaga yun o iba. Okay? So, that is an example of doing an act which results to reckless imprudence. Yung failing to do an act naman, fails to do an act. Si A, pinark niya yung kotse niya in a sloping ground without putting the handbrake. Kaya hindi niya nilagyan ng handbrake or hindi niya nilagyan ng bato dun sa likod ng ano kotse niya. Okay? Sloping yung pinagparkan niya. Ibig sabihin, it's either pababa or pataas. Tapos, may mga batang naglalaro dun sa bandang baba. Dahil si A, hindi niya hinandbrake yung kotse niya or hindi niya nilagyan ng harang dun sa gulong, biglang umatras yung kotse niya. Okay? In result, yung kotse niya, nabangga yung mga bata naglalaro. Okay? So, reckless imprudence yun. Dahil kapabayaan ni A yun. Hindi siya nag-take ng necessary precaution. Hindi niya hinandbrake. Okay? Doing or failing to do an act. Example, where the charge is that the accused allowed their cows and carabaos na maggalagala dun sa premises ng lupa nila. Okay? Tapos dun sa lupa nila, maraming nakatanim na, let's say, mga banana tree. Yung mga banana tree na yan, nagtanim itong si ano, complainant. In spite of several warnings ni complainant doon sa accused, hindi pa rin tinali ng accused yung mga carabaos niya and cows. Okay, so ang result, kinain ng mga carabaos tsaka cows yung tanim na saging ni complainant. So the accused may be convicted to damage to property through reckless imprudence if it is their reckless imprudence in letting loose their animals that resulted in the damage to property. Okay? Failing to keep the animals in the corral or to keep them tied may also constitute reckless imprudence. Diyan sa aso mo, hindi mo natali, in result, nakakagat ng tao. That's reckless imprudence. Okay? Yung lack of foresight naman as negligence. Example, nag-iwan ka ng loaded firearm sa isang upuan. Okay? Tapos naabot ng bata habang naglalaro yung bata, making it possible for the child to pick it up tapos paglaruan niya. Okay? Tapos nagbiglang nag-discharge yung baril na yun, namatay yung bata. That is homicide through reckless negligence. Okay? Hindi. Nag-iwan ka ng baril na loaded dun sa maaabot ng bata. Kapabayaan yun. Okay? So, merong test of negligence na tinatawag. Okay? Paano mo malalaman na ang isang act negligent ba talaga siya? So, ang test for determining whether a person is negligent in doing an act whereby the injury or damage results to the other person or property of another is, ang tanong dyan, would a prudent man in the position of the person whom negligence is attributed foresee the harm to the person injured as a reasonable consequence of the course about to be pursued? Okay? Yung prudent man ba, average man, average intelligent man, may nakikita na ba siyang pwedeng ma-harm dun sa ginagawa niya? Okay? As a reasonable consequence nung gusto niyang gawin or nung ginawa niya or nung hindi niya ginawa. Okay? If ang sagot dyan sa tanong na yan is positive, then the law imposes a duty on the actor to refrain from that course or to take precaution against its mischievous result. Okay? Nire-require ng batas. Kung meron ka na foresee na ikapapahamak ng iba, like diwan mong yung wire ng saksakan mo, ano na, nabalatan na, nakalabas na yung mismong tanso niya. Okay? Eh, alam mo na mayroong mga batang lagi naglalaro. May mga bata kang kasama sa bahay na pwedeng makaapak nun. May mga taong pwedeng makaapak nun sa iyo yung extension na yun. So, the law requires na ayusin mo yun. Takpan mo. Okay? The law imposes a duty on the actor to refrain from that course or to take precaution against its mischievous result. And the result do so constitutes negligence. A reasonable foresight of harm followed by the ignoring of the admonition born of this provision is the constitutive fact in negligence. Okay? Reckless imprudence and force majeure, magkaiba yan. Okay? Where the immediate personal harm or damage to property preventable by the exercise of reasonable care is threatened upon another person or the course of conduct about to be pursued by the actor, his failure to use reasonable care to prevent injury constitutes reckless negligence. Okay? Kapag yung immediate personal harm na yan is may iwasan naman, pero hindi mo tinry gawan ng paraan para maiwasan, that is reckless negligence. Pag sinabi natin force majeure, okay, ito yung mga events na hindi mo mafo-foresee na ganito pala yung mangyayari. Or kahit ma-foresee mo, inevitable siya. Hindi siya maiiwasan. Okay? Take note tayo, yung expression force majeure has a reference to an event which cannot be foreseen. Or which kahit ma-foreseen mo is inevitable. It implies an ordinary circumstance independent of the will of the actor. Yung tipong mangyayari siya kahit anong gawin mo. Kapag ikaw ba nagmamaneo tapos biglang pumutok yung gulong mo tapos nakabangga ka, yung pagputok ba ng gulong is a fortuitous event? Ibig sabihin ba hindi mo ba siya ma-foresee? Okay? Hindi mo ba siya, although foreseen, inevitable ba siya? Okay? Yung pagsabog ng gulong. The answer is it depends, okay? It depends whether or not chinek mo naman siya na maigi, okay naman siya. Okay? Hindi siya pudpud, maganda yung hangin niya. Check mo lahat. Okay? Tapos, pumutok pa rin siya. That is force majeure. Pero kung hindi mo minemaintain pala yung gulong mo, pudpud na, ginamit mo pa rin, tapos nagmamaneo ka, biglang pumutok yan, nakabangga ka, hindi siya fortuitous event. Reckless imprudence yun. Okay? Kung yung defect dun sa kotse mo is easily discoverable, kung sakaling laging chinecheck lang yung kotse mo, easily discoverable siya, tapos nag-fade siya, hindi yun fortuitous event. Okay? Kasi responsibilidad mo na i-check lagi yun. I-check yun tuwing bago mo siya gamitin, check yun araw-araw, i-maintain siya, siguro doon na maayos lahat ng pyesa, responsibilidad mo yun, okay? So, kapag ginagawa mo naman yung responsibilidad yun, lagi mong chine-check, minimake sure mo na proper lahat ng equipments niya, tapos may nangyari pa rin, that is fortuitous event, hindi yung reckless negligence. Kasi, nagawa mo lahat on your part. Okay? Nag-exercise ka ng proper diligence. Kaya, failure to detect mechanical defect, negligence yan. If accused driver assumed the duty of inspecting the vehicle. Kung dun sa brakes, the driver could not have known the defect of the brakes, hindi siya liable. Okay? Chinek niya naman, maayos yung brakes. Okay? Bago yung brakes. Kaso may nag-fail pa rin. Or talagang may factory defect siya na hindi mo malalaman, then hindi ka liable for negligence and hindi ka criminally liable. If he did not know or could not have known that the brakes were defective. Yung second element natin, the doing of the act or the failure to do the act must be voluntary. Okay? Voluntary dapat. So, ibig sabihin, if kunyari yung accused, napilit siya. Let's say, napilit siya by means of irresistible force or uncontrollable fear na gumawa ng isang bagay or napilitan siya na hindi gawin yung dapat niyang gawin dahil nga sa irresistible force or uncontrollable fear. He cannot be held liable for criminal negligence kasi hindi voluntary yung act niya. Okay? Inano siya? Tinakot siya by means of irresistible force. O kaya, baliw siya. Insane. Demented. Okay? So, yung mga acts ng isang insane is not voluntary. So, he cannot be held liable for criminal negligence. Yung minor, under 9 years of age, ha? 9 years of age, hindi pwedeng ma-held liable for negligence. Bakit? Kasi, legally, yung under 9 years old na yan, they are incapable of acting with discernment. Okay, yung pangatlong element natin, that it be without malice. So, criminal negligence presupposes na mayroong lack of intention to commit the wrong done. Okay? But, yung wrong done na yan, it came about due to imprudence on the part of the offender. Okay, walang malice, pero meron siyang lack of intention na, let's say, makabangga ng tao, pumatay. Wala siyang intention na gano'n. Pero nangyari because of the imprudence on the part of the offender. What does, kapag napatunayan na merong intent to kill, then hindi siya killing of a person through imprudence. Hindi siya homicide through imprudence. Okay? But plain homicide under Article 249. Pag napatunayan na may intent to kill. That is malice. Also, one's intent to cause damage due to hate, revenge, or other evil motive is shown, the crime is not damage to property through imprudence, but malicious mischief. Okay? Pang-apat na element natin, that material damage results. So, dapat merong injury dun sa tao or damage to property na nangyari as a consequence ng reckless imprudence or simple imprudence. Okay? So, kung walang material damage, then, walang liability. Okay? Nagmamaneho ka. Well, like that. Examples na lang ng itong element number 5 natin. There is an inexcusable lack of precaution the part of the offender taking into consideration. So, examples natin dito. Si A, nagmamaneho. So, nakita ni A yung vehicle ni B paparating sa opposite direction. Okay? And sobrang lapit na nung vehicle ni B nang hindi na siya pwedeng mag-overtake dun sa nasa harap ni A. Okay? Kasi may another kotse pa ron sa harap ni A. Pero pinilit niya pa rin, pinilit niyang overtaken yung nasa harap niya. As a result, bumangga siya ngayon sa vehicle ni B. Okay, so A did not take the necessary precaution to avoid damage to the property of another, then he is guilty of reckless negligence. When a driver dahil sa mabilis niyang pagmamaneho, let's say driver ng bus, bilis-bilis magpatakbo, marami siyang passenger, sobra-sobra yung passenger niya dun sa bus niya. May mga tayo, may mga kasabit na. Okay, sobra-sobra than that permitted by law and regulations. Okay? Tapos dahil sa sobrang dami, nung nabangga, aksidenteng nabangga si driver. Let's say, hindi niya kasalanan yung ano, yung nabangga siya, let's say, 4-2-8-7, let's say. Eh kaso, nung pagbangga na yun, may mga passenger na namatay, especially mga nakasabit or nakatayo. Liable pa rin siya for reckless imprudence kahit pa hindi niya wala siyang fault dun sa pagbangga. Why? Kasi in the first place, nagbabiolate siya ng traffic regulations. Like I said kanina, ang mga nagva-violate ng traffic regulations always be liable for reckless imprudence kapag may nangyaring masama. Okay, inexcusable yun, yung sobra-sobra yung passenger niya sa bus. Okay. Ano pa? Sa isang case, Garcia Romano, appellant showed an inexcusable lack of precaution nung dinisregard niya yung traffic sign. Okay? Traffic sign na slow down. Hindi siya bumagal. Kahit na nakita rin slow down school zone or pedestrians were crossing. Ah, harurot pa rin siya. Ngayon, may nabangga siya while passing the area. That is reckless imprudence. Okay? He should have observed the diligence of reasonably prudent man by slacking his speed and proceeded cautiously while passing the area. Case ng veneration versus people. Dito, the car was clearly ahead of the trailer truck prior to the collision. Hence, it was incumbent upon the appellant to reduce his speed or mag-brake in order to allow the car to safely negotiate a left turn at the intersection. Failing, thus, in observing the necessary precaution to avoid inflicting injury or damage to other, the court considered the appellant to be recklessly imprudent in operating his vehicle. Okay? So, ano yung basis natin for determining the inexcusable lack of precaution? Paano natin masasabing merong inexcusable lack of precaution? Okay? So, sa pagdedetermine nun, ng inexcusable lack of precaution sa part ng offender, the court must consider yung employment or occupation. Okay? Yung degree of intelligence and physical conditions ng offender and other circumstances regarding person's time and place. Okay? So, dun sa employment occupation na yan, merong case, Kabugaw versus People. Dito, nakapag-commit si offender ng reckless imprudence resulting in homicide dahil sa medical malpractice. Sa case na to, may bata, 10-year-old. Okay? Nagre-reklamo siya ng abdominal pain. Abdominal pain, masakit daw yung tiyan niya. Let's say, 5 p.m. 5 p.m. siya nagre-reklamo. So, yung magulang ng 10-year-old na to, dinila siya sa clinic ni Dr. Kabugaw, isang general practitioner. So si Dr. Kabugaw, binigyan niya yung 10-year-old na mga gamot for the pain. Tapos sinabi niya dun sa magulang na tawagan siya kapag tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung sakit ng tiyan. Okay? Ngayon, due to persistent, talagang masakit yung tiyan ng bata, kinabukasan 4:30 a.m., madaling araw, bumalik sila kay Dr. Kabugaw. Okay, tapos ang sabi ni Dr. Kabugaw, dalhin yung bata sa Nazareth General Hospital sa Dagupan for confinement. Okay? So, na-confine yung bata doon sa hospital, tinake yung mga blood samples niya, nag-ultrasound. Okay? Tapos, mayroong nakitang inflammatory process wherein yung appendicial or yung appendix niya cannot be excluded. Okay? So, si Dr. Kabugaw did a rectal examination dun sa bata. And since yung initial impression was acute appendicitis, nirefer ni Dr. Kabugaw yung bata kay Dr. Inzon. Kasi si Dr. Inzon specialized niya yung mga appendicitis na yan. So, pumunta si Dr. Inzon sa hospital, binasa niya yung CBC, ultrasound result. Tapos nag-order siya ng administration of massive antibiotics and pain reliever dun sa bata. Okay? Tapos, pain lays under observation yung bata for 24 hours. Ngayon, kinabukasan, nagre-reklamo na naman yung bata na masakit yung tiyan niya. Tapos, nakita ng parents na merong namamaga dun sa bandang scrotum niya. Okay? So, kinahapunan, same day, nagsusuka yung bata ng mga green na basta kulay green na yung sinusuka niya, tapos tubig yung dinudumi niya. Okay? So yung mga nurse doon sa hospital, sinabi nila yung condition ng bata kay Dr. Inson. Si Dr. Inson naman, via telephone lang yung mga advice niya. Okay? So si Dr. Inson continued medication to alleviate yung abdominal pain ng bata and diarrhea niya. Okay? Nung gabi na, nagsusuka pa rin yung bata, tapos dudumi pa rin, di makatulog. Okay, kinabukasan, lumala yung condition ng bata. Wala nang malay, binigyan siya ng gamot. Tapos, throughout the day, yung condition ng bata, tuloy-tuloy na nagde-deteriorate. Okay? And, mga bandang hapon, namatay na yung bata. So, ang sabi ng court dito, hinild nila as liable si Dr. Inson. Kasi Dr. Inson failed to observe the required standard care expected from doctors. Okay, it was sufficiently established, na-established sa trial, na may iwasan yung pagkamatay ng bata. Kasi it was necessary na mag-perform ng surgery kay dun sa bata immediately. Pero hindi ginawa ni Dr. Inson, puro gamot yung pinag-a-advise niya, tas through telephone pa. Okay? Kahit na napatunayan, kailangan na ng surgery yung bata. So, Dr. Inson revealed want of reasonable skill and care in attending to the need of nung bata by neglecting to monitor effectively yung developments and changes dun sa condition ng bata during the observation period. Okay? And to act upon the situation after matapos nung 24-hour period, nung tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung sakit ng tiyan, tapos lumala yung condition niya. Okay, wala siya nung kinakailangan siya nung lumalala yung condition ng bata hanggang mamatay yung bata. Okay, as the attending surgeon, he should be primarily responsible sa pagmo-monitor ng condition ng bata. Okay? Kasi siya yung nasa best position considering yung skills and experience niya to know if the patient's condition had deteriorated. Okay? While yung mga resident doctors na on duty nung time na yun could likewise monitor the patient's condition, pero siya yung directly responsible for the patient as the attending surgeon. Indeed, reckless and gross negligence of duty to regulate yung personal responsibility niya to observe the condition of the patient. Again, acute appendicitis was the working diagnosis. Okay? And with the emergence of graver symptoms after 24 hours observation, hindi ginawa yung surgery for no apparent reason. Okay? Among the elements constitutive ng reckless imprudence, ang pinaka-central to a finding of guilt is the conclusive determination na yung accused nag-exhibit siya ng voluntary act without malice, an inexcusable lack of precaution. Okay? Inexcusable na hindi pag-iingat. It is that which supplies the criminal intent so indispensable as to bring the act of mere negligence and imprudence under the operation of the penal law. This is because a conscious indifference to the consequences of the conduct is all that is required from the standpoint of the frame of mind nung accused. Okay? Yung quasi-offenses penalize yung mental attitude or yung condition behind the act, yung dangerous recklessness, yung lack of care or foresight, or yung imprudensya punible. Okay? Unlike yung willful offenses which is punish the intentional criminal act. This is precisely where this court found Dr. Inson to be guilty of his seemingly indifference to the deteriorating condition ng bata, that he, as a consequence, he failed to exercise lack of precaution which eventually naging resulta na matay yung bata. Okay? To be sure whether or not a physician committed an inexcusable lack of precaution in the treatment ng patient niya is to be determined to the standard care observed by other members of the profession in good standing in similar circumstances, bearing in mind the advanced state of the profession at the time of treatment or the present state of medical science. Okay, in accepting a case, yung doctor represents that having the need, training, and skill na possessed by physicians and surgeon practicing in the same field, he will employ such training, care, and skill in the treatment of his patient. Okay? He is therefore has a duty to use at least the same level of care that any other reasonably competent doctor would use to treat a condition under the same circumstances. Sadly, si Dr. Inson did not display that degree of care and precaution demanded by the circumstances. Okay, dun tayo sa employment or occupation. Example yan, yung profession ng pharmacy, nagde-demand siya ng care and skill. And yung gumagawa ng gamot, must exercise a specially high degree, yung highest degree of care known to practical men, so that human life may not be constantly exposed to the danger flowing from the substitution of deadly poisons for harmless medicines. Okay? Other circumstances regarding persons, time, and place. Example niyan, in attempting na mag-overtake another vehicle, yung likod ng jeep driven by the accused, nakabangga ng 60-year-old woman na naglalakad dun sa gilid. Okay? So, yung babae namatay as a result of the impact. Yung driver, nagda-drive lang siya 15 to 25 kilometers per hour lang. So, sabi ng court sa case na yun, the motorist must not only keep within the speed limit but observe due care. Hindi porket nasa speed limit ka, mako-consider na yan as nag-o-observe ka ng due care. Okay? And yung observance of due care na yan is always a function of the surrounding circumstances ng person, time, and place. Yung time of the accident, okay? Baka madulas yung daanan. So, kailangan mag-ingat. Okay? So, the victim was an old woman na naglalakad lang naman dun sa gilid. Okay, let's say maayos ka nagmamaneho. Tapos merong gago sa kabila na o-overtake. So, nandun na siya sa lane mo. Okay, pasalubong na sa'yo. Nasa wrong side of the road siya. So, anong duty mo dun? Okay, so if an approaching vehicle is running on the road, wrong side of the road, dun sa proper lane mo, in order to avoid collision, it becomes the duty mo, ikaw duty, to first notice the approaching vehicle habang malayo pa siya. Okay? To exercise due care under the existing circumstance in conformity with the conduct expected of a reasonably prudent man. As by, kailangan mong bumagal, huminto, o umiwas when there is enough space para dun sa kotse mo. Okay? So, a motorist should assume na yung approaching vehicle on the side of the road, okay, kung nasa maling daanan man siya or nasa gitna siya, therefore will turn to its own right side of the road in time to avoid danger. Okay? He may not be expected to anticipate that the driver of the approaching vehicle will not do so and block his spot. Okay, pag-usapan natin yung right of way ng mga motor vehicles. Okay? So, sa traffic law parlance, yung term na right of way is understood as the right of one vehicle to proceed in a lawful manner in preference to another approaching the vehicle under such circumstance of direction, speed, and proximity as to give rise to a danger of collision unless one of the vehicles grants precedence over the another. Okay? Like, dalawang kotse, let's say nasa parehong ano sila, nasa parehong lane sila, two lanes 'yon. Okay? Parehas silang kakanan. Okay, pag ginawa nila 'yon, so sabay sila nagkanan, magbabanggaan sila. So sino 'yung mauuna sa kanila? Okay, kung sino 'yung mauuna, ibig sabihin siya 'yung may right of way. Sino ba dapat 'yung mauna? Okay, sino ba 'yung dapat mag-proceed in a lawful manner? Okay, so siya 'yung may right of way. Unless na lang na itong taong may right of way is magbibigay siya ng precedence dun sa isa. Okay? Sige, ikaw na mauna. Okay. Although there is authority to the effect that the right of way is merely a statutory creation and nag-e-exist lang siya according to the express statutory provision, it is generally recognized kapag walang batas or ordinance that governs the matter, the vehicle first entering the intersection, kung sino yung unang dumating sa intersection, siya yung entitled sa right of way. Okay? And it becomes the duty ng ibang kotse, ibang vehicle na paparating rin sa intersection to proceed with sufficient care to permit the exercise of such right without danger of collision. Okay, so responsibility na lang na paunahin yung tao na nandun na sa intersection. Okay? Let's say crossing. Okay? So magkasalubong yung kotse, let's say yung isa kakaliwa. E nauna siyang dumating sa intersection. So etong paparating dapat paunahin niya na muna yung kakaliwa kasi siya yung nauna sa intersection. So yun yung may right of way unless na lang magi-give way itong si una para padaanin muna yung makasalubong. Okay? So the right of way is governed by section 42 nung traffic law natin, which is Republic Act number 4136, which provides na kapag dalawang vehicles approach or enter an intersection approximately at the same time, sabay dumating sa intersection, yung driver of the vehicle on the left, okay, shall yield the right of way to the vehicle on the right. Okay, so dapat si nasa left bibigay muna siya ng daan dun sa nasa right. Si nasa right ang merong right of way. Except na lang kapag nag-submit si nasa right, pinauna niya yung nasa left, okay? So the driver of any vehicle traveling at an unlawful speed, okay, hindi makatarungan yung bilis nila, shall forfeit any right which he might otherwise have hereunder. Okay? So, the driver of a vehicle approaching but not having entered an intersection, paparating pa lang siya, hindi pa siya dumarating ng intersection, shall yield the right of way to a vehicle within such intersection. Okay, so dapat magbigay siya doon sa mga vehicles na nandun na sa intersection kung paparating pa lang siya o doon sa mga lumiliko. Okay, provided that the driver of the vehicle turning left has given a plainly visible signal na talagang liliko siya. Okay, the provision governs the situation when two vehicle approach the intersection from the same direction but and one of them intends to make a turn on either side of the road. But the rule embodied in the said provision, also prevalent in traffic statutes sa US, has also been liberally applied sa mga situation in which two vehicles approach an intersection from directly opposite direction at approximately the same time on the same street and one of them attempts to make a left-hand turn in the intersecting street so as to put the other upon his right, the vehicle making the turn being under the duty of yielding to the other. Ay, nevertheless, yung right of way accorded to vehicle approaching an intersection, hindi yan absolute in terms. Okay? It is actually subject to and it is affected by the relative distances of the vehicles from the point of intersection. Thus, whether one of the drivers has the right of way or sometimes stated eh meron siyang status of a favored driver on the highway is a question that permeates a situation where the vehicles approach the crossing so nearly at the same time and at such distances and speed that if either of them proceeds without regard to the other, a collision is likely to occur. Okay? Otherwise stated, yung statutory right of way under Section 42 ng traffic law natin applies only where the vehicles are approaching the intersection at approximately the same time and not where one of the vehicles enter the junction substantially in advance of the other. Okay, whether two vehicles are approaching at the intersection at the same time does not necessarily depend kung sinong vehicles yung pumasok sa intersection una. Okay, rather, it is determined by the imminence of collision when the relative distances and speeds of the two vehicles are considered. Okay? It is said na yung two vehicles na papadarating sa intersection approximately the same time where it would appear to be a reasonable person of ordinary prudence in the position of the driver approaching from the left of another vehicle that if two vehicles continued on their courses at their speed, a collision would likely occur. Hence, yung driver of the vehicle approaching from the left must give right of precedence to the driver of the vehicle on his right. Okay? Nevertheless, yung rule na nagre-require sa driver sa left na mag-yield ng right of way to the driver sa right on approach to the intersection, no duty is imposed upon the driver on the left to come to a dead stop. Hindi niya kailangang huminto. Ang kailangan niya lang is dumating sa intersection with his vehicle under control so that he may yield the right of way to a vehicle within the danger zone on his right. Okay? Hindi siya, he is not bound to wait until there is no other vehicle on his right in sight before proceeding to the intersection, but only wait until it is reasonably safe to proceed. Okay? Thus, sa isang case, it was established that a motorist crossing a through stop street at the right of way of over one making a turn. But if a person making the turn has already negotiated half of the turn and malapit na siya dun sa ano, talagang malapit na siya makaliko, kalahati na, so that he is already visible to the person on the through street, then he is bound to give way to the former. Okay, right of way ng mga police vehicles, fire trucks, and ambulances. So, upon the approach of any police or fire department vehicle or of an ambulance giving audible signal, the driver of every other vehicle shall immediately drive to the same to a position as near as possible and parallel to the right-hand edge of the curb of the highway, clear of any intersection of highways, and shall stop and remain in such position unless otherwise directed by a peace officer until such vehicle shall have passed. Okay? Sa mga motor vehicle overtaking another vehicle naman, yung Section 37 ng Traffic Law, RA 4136, as amended, mandates all motorists to drive and operate vehicles on the right side of the road or highway. Okay? When overtaking another, sakalang sila pupunta sa left, and it should be made only if the highway is clearly visible and free from oncoming vehicle. Mag-overtake lang sila pag clearly visible yung highway and walang paparating. Okay? Overtaking while approaching a curve on a highway where the driver's view is obstructed. Okay, kung pakurbada yan, bawal mag-overtake. Okay? Corollarily, drivers ng mga automobiles when overtaking another vehicle are charged with high degree of care and diligence to avoid collision. Yung obligation nasa kanila to see to it na yung vehicles coming from the opposite direction are not taken unaware by his presence on the side of the road upon which they have the right to pass. Okay? Sa case ng Dumayang versus People, sabi dito, before collision, the passenger bus was cruising along its rightful lane Tapos biglang may tricycle na biglang sumalubong. Okay, nag-swerve bigla, pumasok sa lane ng bus. So the accident would not have happened kung yung tricycle driver nag-stain lang siya sa lane niya and did not recklessly try to overtake another vehicle while approaching a blind curve. Okay? Like sinabi ko kanina, pag mag-overtake sa left lang. Kasi yung pag-overtake from the right shows recklessness and disregard of traffic laws and regulation. Okay? And overtaking a vehicle while another vehicle approaching from the opposite direction is also overtaking still another vehicle is a violation ng Section 59B ng Motor Vehicle Law. Okay? So, kapag merong motor vehicle na paparating or paliko galing sa corner or nasa kurbada, there is a special necessity for keeping to the right-hand side of the road and the driver has not the right to drive on the left-hand side. Okay? Overtaking on or upon approaching curves is in itself a violation of Section 95B of Traffic Rules and Regulations on National Roads Law. Yan yung sinabi sa Section 41 ng RA 4136. Sinabi ko rin kanina, yung driving within speed limit, hindi yan guarantee for joker. Hindi porket nagda-drive ka within the speed limit, eh, nag-o-observe ka na kagad ng joker. Okay? Yung mga speed limits na yan are merely a maxima which are not to be exceeded. So that driving within a certain speed limit is not a guarantee of joker. Yung degree ng care required sa mga nagmamaneho is governed by the speed limits. Eh, hindi siya govern ng mga speed limits rather. But, yung mga circumstances and conditions obtaining at a particular time. Okay? Nasa speed limit ka nga, tapos may ano naman, school zone yan, daming bata, may nabangga ka, masasabi mo ba na nag-observe ka ng joker kasi nasa speed limit ka? Hindi pwede. Okay? So, meron tayong case ng complex crime ng reckless imprudence resulting in multiple homicide with serious physical injuries and less serious physical injuries. Okay? Sa case yan ng People versus De Los Santos. So, pwede magkaroon ng complex crime. May nag-result sa multiple homicide, dami namatay, ang daming seriously physically injured, tapos ang daming less serious physically injured. So, sa case na to, si accused, batang college student, pero experienced driver siya. This accused should have known na yung apply ng brakes or swerve to a safe place immediately upon hearing the fist bumping thuds to avoid further hitting the other victims. Okay? So by his own testimony, it was established na yung road was slippery, madulas. Tapos pababa. And worse, yung place ng incident, medyo mahabog, tsaka madilim. So, dapat si accused nag-observe siya ng joker in accordance with the conduct of reasonably prudent man na mag-ingat, bagalan niya, i-apply niya yung brakes niya. Okay? Or turning to the left side, even if it would mean entering the opposite lane. Okay? There being no evidence that a vehicle was coming from the opposite direction. So it is highly probable na nagda-drive siya at a speed limit at the time. Pero kahit na nagda-drive siya within the speed limits, hindi ibig sabihin nag-e-exercise siya ng joker. Kasi nga, nakadepende yung joker sa existing circumstances and conditions at the time. Madulas, madulas yung daan, pababa, madilim, tapos mahamog. Okay? Considering na yung incident was not a product of malicious intent but rather a result of a single act of reckless driving. Dahil nga nadulas yung kotse niya, ang dami niya nabangga, may mga namatay, may mga nasugatan. Okay? So yung mga nangyari na yun, nag-result yun ng single act of reckless driving. So the accused was guilty of complex crime of reckless imprudence resulting in multiple homicide with serious physical injuries and less serious physical injuries. Take note yung prior conviction or acquittal of reckless imprudence bar the subsequent prosecution for the same quasi offenses. Okay, yung doctrine ng reckless imprudence under Article 365 is a single quasi offense by itself and not merely a means to commit other crimes, such as that conviction or acquittal na mga quasi offenses bar the subsequent prosecution of the same quasi offenses regardless of its various resulting acts. Okay? Undergirded this court's unbroken chain of jurisprudence on doppel jeopardy as applied to Article 365. Okay? Sa case ng People versus Diaz, dito, yung court and bank ordered the dismissal of a case for damage to property through reckless imprudence. Kasi meron nang na-file dati against the same accused, against the same act for reckless driving arising from the same act which the prosecution was based. Okay? Isang beses lang siya nag-reckless driving. Let's say may nabangga siya. So, kinasuhan siya ng reckless driving. Pwede mo pa siyang kasuhan ba ng reckless imprudence resulting to damage to property? Hindi na. Same act eh. Same act nag-base. Kahit pa sabihin natin na dismiss yung una. Since then, whenever the legal question was brought before the court, whether prior conviction or acquittal of reckless imprudence bar the subsequent prosecution for the same quasi offenses, regardless of the other consequences alleged for both charges, the court unfailingly and consistently answered in the affirmative and uniformly barred the second prosecutions as constitutionally impermissible under the double jeopardy clause. Sa case ng People versus Buan, it was held na yung reason and precedent both coincide that in once convicted or acquitted of a specific act ng reckless imprudence, the accused may not be prosecuted again for the same act. Okay? For the essence of quasi-offense of criminal negligence under Article 365 ng RPC, relies in the execution of an imprudent or negligent act if intentionally done would be punishable as a felony. So the law penalizes thus the negligent or careless act, not result thereof. Okay? The gravity of the consequence is only taken into account to determine the penalty. It does not qualify the substance of the offense. Okay? And as the careless act is single, whether the injurious result should affect one person or several persons, the offense, yung criminal negligence, remains one and the same and cannot be split into different crimes and prosecutions. Okay, hindi mo pwedeng, yung dahil sa aksidente may napatay tapos may nasirang property, kinasuha mo siya ng reckless imprudence resulting to homicide. Okay? Pwede mo pa ba siyang kasuhan ulit ng reckless imprudence resulting to damage property? Hindi na pwede. Dahil pinagsama mo sa isa. Thus, isa ba? Accused conviction for reckless imprudence resulting in slight physical injury bars a second prosecution for reckless imprudence resulting in homicide and damage to property arising from the same incident. Okay. Yung regarding sa rule natin na lagi ka dapat nasa right. So, yung motor vehicle pwede siyang mapunta sa left side on the road temporarily. Okay, if yung obstruction exists on the right side ng highway, the driver of a motor vehicle may be justified in passing to the other side and in driving along that side until lumampas na siya dun sa nakaharang sa right side. Okay? And if he exercises the proper diligence of care while there, he is not liable for injuries arising from collision with another vehicle. But if, as dun sa case ng People versus Dian, the immediate cause of accident was the appellant's having made U-turn, nag-U-turn siya ng mabilis and without making the required signal, tapos may nabangga siya, he is liable for the damage cause. Okay, so that is reckless imprudence. Now, let's talk about simple imprudence naman. So, meron dalawang elements lang ang simple imprudence. Una, there is a lack of precaution on the part of the offender. Pangalawa is the damage impending to because is not immediate or the danger clearly not clearly manifest. Okay? Example. Si A nagda-drive ng truck. Okay? Ngayon, nung papasok na si A sa, let's say, tulay, paakyat yung tulay, nakita niya yung truck ni B nandun sa may taas. Okay? So, si B, sabi niya kay A na alisin niya muna yung truck. Okay? So, si C, helper ni B, was requested na talian ng steel cable to the two trucks which were facing each other at a distance about 2 meters at a signal. So, si inatras ni A yung truck niya. Tapos, nung medyo nakaandar na sila, nag-malfunction yung truck ni B. And, sabi ni B kay A, huminto muna. So, si C, tinanggal niya yung tali. It was then that C was sandwiched between the two trucks, resulting in the death of C. Biglang nag-atrasan yung mga trucks. Okay? So, considering the salient physical circumstances surrounding the accident, such as yung narrow distance between the two vehicles, yung inclined positions nila, okay? Yung approximate time kung kailan nangyari, and yung temporary and slippery condition nung tulay. The court believed that the two drivers were negligent when both failed to exercise the necessary and reasonable prudent care in ascertaining before and whether or not their trucks were already untied and the deceased safely and cons prior to maneuvering their vehicles. However, yung negligence na na-exhibit nila does not approximate negligence of reckless nature, but merely amounts to simple negligence. Placing a loaded pistol in one's pocket, from which it fell, resulting in the injury of another when it fired, is not negligence for which one is liable. Okay? The trial court concedes that the only conclusion that may be drawn from the facts is that the shooting was accidental. However, it was held na yung act ng appellant na nilagay niya yung loaded pistol niya at the same pocket as his wallet. Tapos nung binunot niya yung wallet niya, nalaglag sa lapag yung barrel, pumutok, is reckless negligence, and sentencing accordingly. Okay? There is nothing indicable in the appellant act of placing yung loaded pistol niya at the same pocket ng wallet niya. It does not even rise to the level of negligence. Okay? The said pistol fell when the wallet was pulled out from the appellant's pocket does not make the situation any worse. Besides, even yung act ng appellant be in any way considered imprudent, the same nevertheless could not be the proximate cause of the complainant's injury. So, aksidente na laglag yung barrel and it was in the course of the appellant's act of safekeeping the same, an altogether lawful act, pumutok. The accidental dropping of the pistol was at least an independent intervening cause which interrupted the chain of causation between the act labeled below as negligent and the injury cause. So, no liability could thus be imputable to the appellant on that score, nor may firing of the pistol be regarded as negligent. Yung essence ng negligent act is that it be, in every case, voluntary. Okay? Dito, yung pagputok ng barrel was purely accidental. It took place precisely while the appellant was making an effort to prevent it from causing injury. Okay? Si appellant himself was injured hereby. From all aspects, therefore, appellant incurred no criminal liability. Okay? Doon tayo sa penalty. So, when the execution of the act covered by this article resulted in damage to property, like I said kanina, yung penalty is only fine. Okay? Hindi imprisonment. take note yung when reckless imprudence or simple imprudence or negligence resulted in the damage to property of another, the penalty is only fine, hindi imprisonment, ranging from an amount equal to the value ng damages or 3 times of such value, but shall not be less than 5,000 pesos. Okay. Sample. Isang passenger bus, isang passenger bus nakabangga ng terrace of a commercial apartment. Okay? So, yung driver was convicted of reckless imprudence resulting in damage to property. The accused, yung nagmamaneho, was sentenced to suffer imprisonment for 1 year and bayaran yung may-ari ng terrace a reasonable compensation sustained by plaintiff for damages to her apartment. Compensatory and exemplary damages, attorney's fees, cost of the suit. Ganyan. Pinagbayad sa kanya lahat yun. Sabi ng court sa case na yun, nagkamali daw yung lower court in sentencing the accused a straight penalty of 1 year. Kasi sabi sa third paragraph ng Article 365, fine lang. Okay, when the execution ng reckless imprudence nag-result lang sa damage to property, dapat fine lang. Okay? Yung measure ng damage should be the difference in value of the property immediately before the incident and immediately after the repair. Okay? So, yung itong 365 being a penal legislative provision must be interpreted strictly. Okay, and consistent with this theory, it is our considered opinion na yung damage to property of another provided sa third paragraph as the basis of fine therein prescribed, eh yung market value ng property destroyed at the time and place of its destruction. Okay? Kunyari, ang nasira, cellphone mo, pero yung cellphone mo, bago pa siya nasira through reckless imprudence, eh talagang sira-sira na siya. So, hindi na siya mabebenta. Let's say, binili mo siya ng 10K. Ngayon, supposed to say, mabebenta mo pa siya ng 10K ulit kung sakaling maayos pa yung condition niya. Eh, hindi na. Basag-basag na yung screen, dami ng gas-gas. Okay? So, hindi mo na siya mabebenta for 10K. Ngayon, nasira, lalong nasira yung cellphone na yun dahil sa reckless imprudence ng iba. Ngayon, ang fine ba is yung 10K na original price nung cellphone mo? Siyempre, hindi. Ang market value nung nasirang property is kung ano yung condition niya at the time na nasira siya. Okay? Siyempre, kasama yung reasonable expenses incurred na ginamit to preserve or restore the property to its former form and condition. Pati yung pagpapaayos. Kasama yun. Yung Article 64 natin relative to mitigating and aggravating circumstances is not applicable to crimes committed through negligence. Okay, so yung paragraph 5 ng Article 365 expressly states that in the imposition of penalties provided for dito sa article na to, the court shall exercise their sound discretion without regard to the rules prescribed in Article 64. Okay? The rationale ng batas na ito can be found in the fact na yung quasi-offenses penalizes under Article 365 yung carelessness, imprudence, or negligence, which characterizes the wrongful act may vary one situation to another. In nature, yung extent resulting consequences, and in order that there may be a fair and just application ng penalty, yung courts meron silang ample discretion in its imposition. Okay, kahit hindi nila sundin yung mitigating and aggravating circumstance na computation doon sa Article 64. Okay? Sa Article 64 kasi specific eh. Na kapag may isang mitigating circumstance, gagawin minimum lang. Pag isang aggravating, maximum, offset. So, merong established formula or established computation sa Article 64. Okay, pero pag dating sa 365, hindi kailangang sundin ni court yung computation na yun. Under discretion nila kung paano nila ite-take yung mitigating or aggravating circumstance na present doon sa current case. Okay, the trial court is not bound to apply paragraph 5 ng Article 64 kahit na yung accused meron siyang dalawang mitigating circumstance in his favor and no aggravating circumstance to offset them. Okay? Yung penalties provided sa 365 hindi applicable sa following cases na to. Yung una is yung pag yung penalty provided for the offense is equal to or lower than those provided sa first two paragraphs ng Article 65, in which case the court shall impose the penalty next lower in degree than that which should be imposed in the period which they may deem proper to apply. Okay? Take note, yung penalty ng arresto mayor in its minimum and medium periods na provided sa first paragraph ng 365 for committing any act had it been intentional would constitute a less grave felony. Itong penalty na to should not be imposed if less serious physical injuries lang ang cost, hindi grave felony. Okay? Because the penalty for less serious physical injuries committed with malice is arresto mayor. In such case, yung penalty ng arresto menor, which is the next lower in degree dun sa arresto mayor, should be imposed to preserve the difference between the penalty for intentional felony and that for culpable penalty. Okay? So, dapat merong diferensya between dun sa penalty ng intentional and culpable. I-make sure ng court na mas mababa yung penalty ng culpable. Pangalawa, hindi nag-a-apply kapag when by imprudence or negligence with violation of the automobile law, death of a person shall be caused, in which case the defendant shall be punished by prison correctional in its medium and maximum period. So the highest penalty prescribed under the first paragraph is arresto mayor in its maximum period to prison correctional in its medium period. Okay? Yung first exception applied, yung unang exemption natin dyan, to be precise, yung paragraph 1 ng Article 365, nagpe-prescribe siya ng penalty of 21 to 30 days of arresto menor for light felonies committed through reckless imprudence. However, yung paragraph 6 ng article na to, merong exemption. Okay? Ito yon. Ito yung nasa una. So when the provisions contained sa Article 365 hindi applicable kung yung penalty provided for the offense is equal to or lower than those provided in the first two paragraphs of this article, in which the court shall impose the penalty next lower in degree than that should be imposed in the period which they may deem proper to apply. Okay? Let's say, kunwari lang to ah, let's say ang homicide ay punishable by reclusion perpetua. Temporal na lang. Yung proper penalty niya, temporal homicide. Okay? Ah, hindi. Baguhin natin. Okay, let's say na lang yung offense na nagawa mo, reckless imprudence through resulted in ganito. So, kapag intentional yung nagawa mo, ang magiging penalty mo is, let's say, arresto mayor in its minimum period. Ayun yung penalty for the intentional offense. Kung sakaling intentional man yung ginawa mo. Eh hindi. Reckless imprudence siya. Eh kaso, sabi sa reckless imprudence, pag nag-constitute ng grave felony, which is yung act mo is grave felony, ang magiging penalty mo is arresto mayor in its maximum period, which is ang pinrovide na itong 365, mas mataas na penalty kesa dun sa penalty na dapat makukuha mo kung sakaling intentional. Pwede ba yung ganun? Hindi pwede. Okay? So kapag mas mataas yung penalty na pinrovide na itong Article 365 kesa dun sa penalty ng act na ginawa mo kung sakaling intentional siya, hindi applicable yung penalty na binigay ng 365. So, dapat ang magiging penalty is mas mababa doon sa penalty ng act na ginawa mo should have been intentional. Okay? Ang underlying reason for this reduction in penalty is to preserve the difference between the act willfully performed and one committed through negligence. Take note, laging mas mababa ang penalty ng isang act committed through negligence kesa intentional. Okay? Another, Article 266 ng RPC, penalty provided for slight physical injuries is aresto menor, which is imprisonment from 1 to 30 days. Okay, 1 to 30 days. Ngayon, kapag sinunod natin yung penalty dito sa 365, let's say yung slight physical injuries na commit mo yan through reckless imprudence. Kung susundin natin dito yung 365, magiging parehas lang yung penalty mo kesa dun sa penalty na pinrovide ng slight physical injury for intentional. So, magiging parehas. So, walang pinagkaiba. So, ang gagawin ng court, pag ganun, bababaan nila yung penalty dito sa reckless imprudence. Okay? The proper penalty, therefore, for the crime of slight physical injuries through reckless imprudence is the penalty next lower in degree to aresto mayor. And this is magiging public censure lang. Okay? So, ito yung exemptions, mga exemptions kung kailan hindi ma-apply yung mga penalties na sinabi sa first two paragraphs ng Article 365. Okay? Yung pangalawa, when death or injury to any person has resulted, the motor vehicle driver at fault shall be punished under the revised penal code. Okay, so yung RA 4136 natin, yung Land Transportation and Traffic Code natin, provides na if yung as a result ng negligence or reckless imprudence or unreasonable fast driving, any accident occurs resulting in the death or injury of any person, the motor vehicle operator at fault shall upon conviction punish under the provisions of the RPC. Okay? Contributory negligence, hindi yan defense. Okay? Only mitigates criminal liability. Let's say, hindi ikaw yung naka-aksidente pero nagko-contribute ka dun sa negligence na nangyari. So, the defense of contributory negligence does not apply in criminal cases through reckless imprudence since one cannot allege the negligence of another to evade the effects of his own negligence. Okay, let's say ikaw ang trabaho mo is i-inspect araw-araw yung kotse ng amo mo. Okay? Isang araw hindi mo in-inspect yung kotse niya. Sabi mo okay na 'yan. Okay, hindi mo alam faulty na pala yung brakes. Ngayon etong amo mo naman ang bilis magmaneho. So pare may negligence din sa part niya. Ngayon mabilis siya magmaneho, bigla siya nag-brake, hindi kumagat yung brake niya, nakabangga siya. Okay, ikaw ba na ang trabaho mo i-inspect yung kotse, liable ka ba dun? Eh, hindi naman ikaw yung mabilis na nagpatakbo, hindi ikaw yung nakabangga. Okay, may negligence din naman sa part ng amo mo dahil mabilis siya nagpatakbo. Pero kasama ka ba sa magiging liable? Yes, contributory negligence yun. Trabaho mo rin na inspect yung brakes niya, hindi mo ginawa. But where the proximate cause of death is the negligence of the deceased himself. Okay, ang dahilan kung bakit namatay yung isang tao ay dahil sa sarili niyang kagagawan at hindi dahil sa negligence ng accused na driver. Hindi pwedeng maging liable si driver for homicide. Paano naman yung concurrent proximate cause ng two negligent drivers? Dalawa yung parehas silang negligent. So, the two defendants, by their speeding and overtaking vehicles ahead, even encroaching on others' lanes without taking due precaution as required by the circumstances, were held guilty of negligence, which was the proximate cause of the collision. So, where the concurrent or successive negligent acts or omission of two or more persons, although acting independently of each other, are in combination the direct and proximate cause of a single injury to a third person, it is impossible to determine in what proportion each contributed to the injury, either is responsible for the whole injury, even though his act alone may not have caused the entire injury.
Okay?
Dalawang negligent driver nagbanggaan. Okay? Nung nagbanggaan sila, may tumilapon na pyesa. Tumama sa ibang tao. Nag-cause ng injury. Sinong liable dun sa injury ng third person na yon? Pareho. Okay? Both negligent drivers. Dahil pareho sila nagkaroon ng contribution dun sa collision. Ang reason behind this legal principle is that yung negligence ng isang tao is no sense justified by the concurring negligence of another. Hindi porket naging negligent din yung iba, absuelto ka na sa sarili mong negligence. Okay, sa 365, meron tayong tinatawag dyan na doctrine of last clear chance. Okay? Yung doctrine of last clear chance, in essence, is to the effect that where both parties are negligent, kung parehong parties are negligent, pero yung negligent act of one is appreciably later in time than on another. Or when it is impossible to determine whose fault or negligence should be attributed to the incident, the one who had the last clear chance opportunity to avoid the impending harm failed to do so is chargeable with the consequences thereof. Okay? Dalawang kotse, magkasunod. Okay? Pareha sila nasa right of way. Ngayon, yung rule doon sa dinadaanan nila, bawal huminto. Let's say, nasa inlik sila. Ngayon, siyempre, bawal huminto. Ngayon, medyo malayo naman doon nasa likod. Okay? Eh, kaso yung nasa harap, biglang huminto, kahit bawal. So, may negligent act. Kasi pag hinto niya na yun, nabiglaan, pwedeng mag-cause ng accident. Okay? So, itong nasa likod, although nakita niya na kagad na huminto, kaya hindi pa siya umiwas, may time siya na umiwas, hindi niya ginawa. May time siya na huminto, hindi niya ginawa. Dire-diretso pa rin siya kasi ang nasa isip niya, nasa right of way ako. Bawal huminto dyan, buhuminto ko eh. Ngayon, nabangga niya ngayon. Okay? Masasabi mo ba na hindi siya liable kasi nasa right of way naman siya yung bumangga? Hindi. Dahil nasa kanya yung last clear chance. Last clear chance na umiwas sa impending harm. Kaya nasa kanya yung last clear opportunity to avoid impending harm. And dahil hindi niya yung ginawa, chargeable siya with the consequences thereof. Okay, stated differently, the rule would also mean that an antecedent negligence of a person does not include the recovery of damages for supervening in negligence or bar a defense against liability sought by another if the latter who had last fair chance could have avoided impending harm by the exercise of due diligence. In accordance with the doctrine ng last clear chance, yung contributory negligence of a party injured will not defeat the action if it be shown that the accused might, by the exercise of reasonable care and prudence, maiiwasan niya pa yung consequence of the negligence of the injured party. Pero hindi niya lang ginawa. Okay? Kasi pinilit niya yung karapatan niya. Thus, another truck nakapark sa wrong side of the road. Tapos nabangga, nakapark. Ngayon, itong paparating na sakyan, talagang dire-diretso siya. Binaliwala niya yung truck na nakapark dyan. Ngayon, tumama siya dun sa truck, na-injured siya. Wala ba siyang liability ron? Because despite the admitted fact, si accused, yung nagmamaneho, had the time and opportunity to avoid the mishap kung sakaling nag-ingat siya. Okay? So, meron tayong tinatawag dito na emergency rule. Okay? The rule is stated thus, an automobile driver who by negligence of another, hindi own negligence niya, is suddenly placed in an emergency and compelled to act instantly to avoid a collision or injury, is not guilty of negligence. If he makes such a choice, which a person of ordinary prudence placed in such position might make, even though he did not make the wisest choice.
Okay?
Let's say, kurbada, may nag-o-overtake, ikaw, nasa proper lane ka. Siyempre, pakurba yun, hindi mo nakikitang may umu-overtake pala. So, meron negligent yung taong umu-overtake na yan. Ngayon, nagulat ka, bigla mong iniwas yung kotse mo. Okay? Yun yung normal na response, eh. Iiwas mo yung kotse mo. Tatry mong huminto. Okay? Tatry mong bumagal. In the process, may nabangga ka. Liable ka ba dun sa taong nabangga mo? Hindi. Okay? Ayan yung emergency rule. Okay? The act of a motorist at in attempting to pass a car in front of him at the moment when another vehicle is approaching constitutes gross negligence and renders him liable for any damage resulting from the act. So, ang may kasalanan, yung taong umu-overtake ng mali, kahit pa hindi siya nakabangga. Okay? Itong emergency rule, hindi ito ma-apply kung ikaw merong negligence din sa part mo. Eh, paano kung wala? Maayos ka lang na nagmamaneho. Sumusunod ka sa lahat. You are exercising proper diligence. Pero dahil sa loko na to, na biglang sumulpot, ikaw, natural na gagawin mo, eh, tatry mong umiwas. So, sa pag-iwas mo, may nabangga ka. Hindi ka liable dun. Siya ang liable. Yung taong biglang sumulpot. Okay, next is the applicability ng emergency doctrine. So, a person who is confronted with sudden emergency may be left no time for thought. Must make a speedy decision based largely upon impulse or instinct. Like yung mga example ko kanina. So, hindi siya pwede ma-held liable to the same conduct as one who had the opportunity to reflect even though it later appears that he made a wrong decision. Okay? So, mag-a-apply ang emergency rule. Yung tipong wala ka ng time para mag-isip. Para ma-determine kung tama ba yung course of action mo. Okay, as long as wala kang negligent na ginagawa. But the emergency doctrine, applicable lang yan where the situation which arises to confront the actor is sudden, biglaan, and unexpected, hindi mo inaasahan. And itong event na ito, dapat dineprive ka of all opportunity for deliberation. Hindi ka na makakapagsip. Hindi mo na madedetermine which is the best course of action. Okay? A further qualification which must be made is that some emergencies must be anticipated and the actor must be prepared to meet them when he engages in an activity from which they are likely to arise. Okay? So, like pag nagmamaneho ka, merong high degree of care na kinakailangan. If a person has knowledge that unusual consequence may result from his negligent act, pwede siya maging liable for the injurious consequence of such act, notwithstanding it is not the ordinary consequence of an act of that kind. Okay, the emergency rule, magkaiba yan sa last clear chance doctrine. Okay? Magkaiba yan. Sinabi yan sa case ng Engada versus Court of Appeals. So, in this case, si Iran, nagda-drive siya ng Toyota Tamaraw Jeepney papuntang Iloilo City. Okay? Tapos, si Seyan, isa sa mga pasahero niya. So, habang binabaybay nila yung daanan sa Barangay Akwit, yung Tamaraw passengers allegedly saw from the opposite direction, eh merong mabilis na Isuzu pickup. Say, sa kabilang side ng road driven by the petitioner. Okay, the pickup has just negotiated a hilly gradient on the highway. When it was just a few meters away from the Tamaraw, eh biglang malapit na siya sa Tamaraw, saka lang siya nag signal light. Okay, at the same time, it swerved to its left, encroaching upon the lane of the Tamaraw and headed towards an head-on collision with the course of it. Okay? So, si Seyan, sinigawan niya si Iran na iwasan yung pickup. So, si Iran, umiwas sa left niya, Tapos itong pick up, umiwas din, sabay silang umiwas. So, anong nangyari? Nagbanggaan pa rin sila. Okay? Yung impact na nag-cause ng head and chassis nung Tamaraw to separate from its body. Okay? Tapos si Seiyan tumilapon sa labas ng jeep. Okay? Tapos tumilapon siya dun sa may palayan. So, si Seiyan at Iran were brought to the hospital. Si Seiyan nag-incur ng medical expenses and yung Toyota Tamaraw jeepney napunta sa junk shop. So, etong si nagdadrive ng pickup was guilty of simple imprudence resulting in physical injuries and damage to properties. Okay, so nagpetition siya sa CA. Tinry niya extricate himself from liability by invoking the doctrine of last clear chance. He avers that between him and Iran, si Iran daw yung may last clear chance to avoid collision. Hence, si Iran daw dapat yung liable, hindi siya. So, sabi ng court dito, yung last clear chance doctrine states that a person who has the clear chance or opportunity or of avoiding an accident, notwithstanding the negligent acts of his opponent, is considered in law solely responsible for the consequence of the accident. However, walang convincing evidence na binigay itong si petitioner, yung driver ng pickup, to support na si Iran talaga yung may last clear chance. Instead, ang nakita ng court is the presence of an emergency sa part ni Iran na umiwas. Okay, in-apply yung emergency rule. So, yung petitioner's act of swerving to the Tamaraw lane at a distance of 30 meters from it and driving the Isuzu pickup at nang mabilisan habang papalapit siya dun sa Tamaraw, denied Iran the time and opportunity to ponder on the situation at all. Okay? Walang clear chance na nangyari. Accordingly, sabi ng Court of Appeals, the CA did not err in holding the petitioner responsible for the vehicular collision and resulting damages, including the injuries suffered by Seiyan and total loss of the Tamaraw jeepney. So, kasalanan lahat nung driver ng pickup yon. Walang clear chance dun sa part ni Iran dahil mabilis ka tapos saka ka nag-serve, malapit ka na dun sa Tamaraw, hindi na nakapag-isip ng maayos si Iran. So, ang ginawa niya, out of instinct, bigla siyang kumaliwa. Tapos ikaw, kumanon ka rin, resulta nagbanggaan pa rin kayo. So, walang last clear chance sa part ni Iran. Okay, a person, like nasabi ko na kanina, violating a traffic regulation is presumed negligent. Okay, unless there is proof to the contrary. Kaya ba't yung negligence na yan cannot be predicated upon the mere fact of minority or lack of a driver's license? The penalty next higher in degree to be imposed if yung offender fails to lend on-spot help to injured person. So, yung last paragraph ng Article 365, okay, yung last paragraph niya, provides for the penalty next higher in degree upon the offender who failed to lend on the spot help to the victims of his own negligence. Yung kapabayaan mo, meron kang mga naging biktima. Tapos yung mga naging biktima mo, hindi mo man lang tinulungan, tinakbuhan mo. Okay, so ang magiging penalty mo is next higher in degree. Okay. Article 275 penalizes with arresto mayor anyone who shall fail to help or render assistance to another whom he has accidentally wounded or injured. Okay? Yan yung last paragraph. Okay, ito. So, failing to lend help, okay, hindi mo pagtulong dun sa mga nabiktima mo, is a qualifying circumstance. Okay, the failure to render assistance constitutes a qualifying circumstance because the presence thereof raises the penalty by 1 degree, like treachery, which qualifies homicide to murder. So the same must be alleged in the information to apprise the defendant of his charge. Unlike the ordinary aggravating circumstances, which, even if not alleged in the information, can be taken into account if proved at the trial without objection. So, dahil qualifying aggravating yan, dapat i-allege yan sa information. Hindi yan katulad ng normal na aggravating na basta mapatunayan, pwede i-count. Si defendant, hindi siya criminal liable for death or injuries caused by his recklessly negligent acts to trespassers whose presence in the premises he was not aware of. Ay, case ng People versus Quadra. Si A, nagda-drive siya ng cargo truck. Okay? So, hindi niya alam. May mga sumakay pala dun sa truck niya, sa likod. So, habang nagda-drive siya, which has medyo pataas, tapos ano, madulas. Ngayon, dahil nga madulas, tapos pataas, kahit na sobrang ingat niya, nag-swerve pa rin yung truck niya sa right side of the road. Okay? And thus, yung gulong natanggal. Okay? So, si A, in an effort to regain the center of the road, minaunobra niya yung truck niya. Tapos, nagka-aberya. Tapos, itong si B, tsaka si C, na nakisakay doon sa likod na hindi alam ni A, biglang tumilapon. Okay? Ngayon, namatay as a consequence. So, with respect doon sa namatay or sa kung sakaling injured man, there can be no question that had the acts which caused them been intentional, it would constitute a grave felony or less felony, respectively. And acts of this kind committed through reckless imprudence are penalized under 365 RPC. Pero, it is clear that the provisions ng Article 365 contemplate in a situation in which A could be held to owe to the victim the duty not to expose him to a danger or injury. Okay? It is necessary that the victim be in the premise with the same color of right and that A had knowledge nung presence nung namatay. So, if yung victim is a mere trespasser, tapos si A, hindi siya aware yung presence ng trespasser na yun. The latter is only liable for injuries resulting from willful and wanton acts. Pero hindi for those resulting from his negligence. Such as in the rule in torts and in criminal cases both here and in American jurisprudence. Okay? Sa case naman ng People versus Mier, si defendant was accused of homicide through reckless imprudence dahil nakapatay ng 11 years old na bata who, in childish flooring, clung to the sides of the appellant vehicle for joyride. Itong 11 year old na bata na ito, sumabit dun sa sakyan ng defendant nang hindi alam nung defendant. Okay? Tapos, nung nagka-aksidente, namatay yung bata, inacquit ng court yung defendant. Kasi sabi ng court, no man can be punished for not taking precautions to prevent injuries to persons that act at his back. Okay? Hindi niya naman alam na may tao eh. So, hindi siya pwede ma-held for reckless imprudence. Ang isang quack doctor who treated a sick man resulting in the latter's death is guilty of homicide through reckless imprudence. Okay? So, yung allegation sa information na yung accused acted with reckless imprudence and negligence sa pagda-diagnose and pag-treat ng nung namatay, knowing na hindi naman talaga doktor tong tao na to. And dahil doon, namatay yung nagpa-check up sa kanya. Sufficiently charged the crime of homicide through reckless imprudence since ordinary diligence counsel her not to tamper with human life by trying to treat a sick man. Okay, nagpanggap siya na doktor, may nagpa gamot sa kanya, namatay dahil sa kagagawa niya, hindi yun homicide. Okay, that is homicide through reckless imprudence. inexcusable lack of precaution by physician, paano dinedetermine yan? So sa case ng Cruz versus Court of Appeals, sabi, whether or not a physician has committed an excusable lack of precaution sa treatment ng patient niya is to be determined according dun sa standard of care observed by other members of the profession in good standing under similar circumstances, bearing in mind yung advanced state of the profession at the time of treatment or the present state of medical science. Okay? Okay, let's say merong sakit sa, merong cancer na wala pang cure, wala pang treatment, wala pang kahit ano. Okay? Pero, merong pasyente na ganun yung sakit na lumapit kay Dr. A. Okay, so, ginawa ni Dr. A lahat na makakaya niya, pero namatay pa rin itong pasyente. Dahil nga wala pang cure sa ganun, liable ba si Dr. A? Masasabi mo ba na duty niya na i-treat yung tao na yun? Hindi, because kailangang i-bear in mind yung advanced state ng science at the time of the treatment. Okay? Yung present state ng medical science na yan, it is impossible pa na ma-treat yung tao na yun. Okay? Magiging liable lang yung doctor if yung treatment, yung conduct ng physician falls below regular standard. Okay? Burden of proof in litigation involving medical negligence, nasa plaintiff yun. Okay? In litigations involving medical negligence, the plaintiff has the burden of establishing appellant's negligence for a reasonable conclusion of negligence. Dapat merong proof of breach of duty on the part of the surgeon as well as a casual connection of such breach and the resulting death of his patient. Okay? Where the attending physician was absolved of liability for the death of the complainant's wife and newborn baby, ang sabi ng court, in order that they may be recovery for an injury, however, it must be shown na yung injury for which recovery is sought must be the legitimate consequence of the wrong done. The connection between the negligence and yung injury must be a direct and natural consequence of events unbroken by intervening efficient causes. In other words, yung negligence must be the proximate cause of the injury. Okay? For negligence, no matter what it consists, cannot create a right of action unless it is the proximate cause of the injury complained of. And the proximate cause of an injury is that cause which, in natural and continuous sequence, unbroken by any intervening causes, produces the injury and without which the result would not have occurred. Okay, so that is quasi-offenses. Okay? Article 365, imprudence and negligence. Right?